Hi students, welcome to the session on uniform plane wave equation. Right, so here what we are going to prove is for a uniform plane wave UPW propagating in any direction, right, so the component of electric field and the magnetic field is not present in that direction. This is the proof we are going to give. That means if a plane wave, uniform plane wave, is propagating in x direction, right? So x is a direction of propagation, then the component of E, that is E and H in the direction, is 0. E and EX and HX is equal to 0. This is what we are going to prove, right? Let us see that. Here I prove for EX, the same law is applicable for HX also, right? How we are going to prove? The proof is, it is a derivation of uniform plane wave equation. You can say both, right? So we know that the equation for a wave equation is given by del squared E is equal to dou squared E by dou t square. Fine. So del squared E we write as del squared E is equal to dou squared E by dou x square plus dou squared E by dou y square plus dou squared E by dou z square. Fine. So here you see we assume that x is a direction of propagation. Right, so since x is the direction of propagation, dou by dou y is 0 because the variation along y is 0, and dou by dou z is also 0. Right, so what will happen? So this equation will become, it will be simply dou squared E by dou x square. Fine, so it will be like that. Dou squared E by dou A square, right hand side is dou squared E by, wave equation is, we have to include mu epsilon. So mu epsilon dou squared E by dou T square. So dou square mu epsilon dou squared E by dou T square, right? So we write E as EX I vector plus EY J vector plus EK K vector. It's a field quantity, right? It varies in all directions, right? That we know. Clear? So we can write E as EXI, EYJ and EZG. So when you take right hand side, so what will happen to dou squared E vector? Dou squared E vector divided by dou X square. Dou squared E vector divided by dou x squared. I can write this is also a vector. So I can split this into dou squared E by EX. Dou squared EX. Again, E is EXI, EYJ, EZK. So it has three components. So dou squared EY by dou x squared plus dou squared EZ by dou Z square. It is Z, right? So E I can write as EX component, EY component, EZ component. Right hand side also we have mu epsilon common dou squared EX by dou T square plus dou squared EY by dou T square. Plus dou squared EZ by dou T square. When you substitute E is equal to this one and find all the things, you will get this. Okay. So you will get this one. Then I equate left hand side and right hand side. So it will be giving dou squared EX by dou X square is equal to mu epsilon dou squared EX by dou T square. I equate X component, Y and Z. Fine. So similarly So everywhere you can put E is equal to I. So you put E X I J K I J K. Right? What happens when you differentiate? This is Y. E Y by dou X 0. E Z by dou X 0. Similarly here only E Y will be there. X and Z 0. Here only Z will be there. X and Y will be 0. The same thing. Simply right hand side we apply. So if equate left and right, so it will be dou squared E Y by dou X squared, that is equal to mu epsilon dou squared E Y by dou T square, and dou squared E Z by dou Z dou X square, that is equal to mu epsilon dou squared E Z by dou T square, right? So here we are going to work with free space. So we know Gauss law is given by delta D 0. The delta D is equal to rho V. In free space, delta D is equal to 0, because rho V is equal to 0 in free space. This implies delta D is 0. Right, delta D is 0. So delta D, how can I write? Dou E is EXI, EY, EYJ, EZK. So dou EX by dou X plus dou E by dou Y plus dou EZ by dou Z is equal to 0. Fine. So we already know dou by dou Y, dou by dou Z is equal to 0. So this will be 0. What we have is dou EX by dou X is equal to 0. Fine. So if you substitute, so that is the thing, dou ex by dou x equal to 0. Here you see, here we have only dou ex by dou y. So that is equal to 0. So what will happen? Here you see in equation, in this equation, right? So dou squared ex by dou y squared is equal to mu squared mu epsilon dou squared ex by dou t square, right? Here if you substitute, what you will get, this will be 0, because dou ex by dou x equal to 0, right? So here you substitute dou ex by dou x squared 0. This implies 0 is equal to mu e dou squared ex by dou t squared is equal to 0. This implies dou squared ex by dou squared ex by dou t squared is equal to 0. Clear? So this is the thing, we have got it. Right? So what I get? Dou ex by dou x, I substitute 0. Dou ex by dou x 0 means dou squared ex by dou x squared also 0. So that is equal to this one. So what we get is dou squared ex by dou t squared is equal to 0. So this implies dou squared ex divided by dou t squared is equal to 0. When it is possible? It is possible when ex is equal to constant. When ex is equal to constant, the differentiation of constant is 0. Otherwise, ex is equal to 0. Or third condition, when ex varies as a function of time or constant function of time, ex is equal to kt, right? So these are all the three conditions possible to satisfy this equation. See, this is constant differentiation 0, differentiation of 0 is 0. Or how this kt gives 0, you see, when k varies as a function of time, it is going linearly. So here to here it is 2 means here to here also 2, it is a linear function. So what is the change? Second order differentiation will give 0. Why? So if you substitute dou squared kt by dou t squared, what you will get? K into, this is k into dou squared t by dou t squared, that will be 0. Right? So these are all the three conditions possible. Fine. So out of these three conditions, these two will not form a wave. Right, these are all not forming a wave. Only this is possible to have a wave. So this means Ex is equal to 0 is the only possible solution. So what is the meaning here, right? So what is the direction of propagation we have taken? We have taken direction of propagation is x. So if x is a direction of propagation, we proved that the electric field along x is zero. That is, electric field component, x component of electric field is zero. Similarly, we can prove x component of magnetic field is also zero. That is very, very, very important point. For example, here you see, this is what our wave propagates. Let us assume this is y, this is x, z, this is x, right? So we have proved that our wave is propagating in x direction. That means wave goes in this direction, right? Suppose if electric field is in y direction, fine, the magnetic field will be in z direction. Okay, so what is the thing here? You see, simply it will be having this role, right? Here propagates wave propagation, here it will be h, right? We can say that here you see here EY and HZ are perpendicular to, EY is, HZ is in this direction, perpendicular to x-axis. What is x-axis? Direction of propagation. So EY and HZ are perpendicular to direction of propagation. And you see EY and HZ lie in the ZY plane or YZ plane, right? So you see, this is like a plane which is YZ plane. So when the wave propagates, it appears that this plane is propagating. That's why it is known as uniform plane wave, right? If you consider this full shape, it is like a plane. So when propagates in this direction, it is appearing that this is going, that means this YZ plane is propagating. That's why it is known as uniform plane wave. Why it is called uniform? Here magnitude of E and H are same or constant everywhere, right? That's why it is called uniform plane wave. That is very, very important. So what is the other thing we have to remember here is, here you see EX is 0, X component of E 0, and H component of EX is also 0, and dou by dou y is equal to dou by dou z, that is also 0. Right, now hope you understand why it is called plane wave, what is plane wave and all, right? So that's all about this session. If you have any doubt, please ask me in comment section. Thank you.